No, I've got a question to ask you.
What?
What's happening with the, what do you call them, the Palestinian? Have you heard from him?
I never did hear from him, right? But he started everywhere I went, everywhere, you know, if I was...
Okay, fair enough, so
if I start talking about him, I can guarantee you he would walk around this corner.
Right. What was the final outcome of that evening?
In the morning.
Aye, what happened in the morning?
No, it happened in the morning. No, please don't laugh. You know, when I think, you know, I live at where I do. There I was. I'd missed my last train. It did occur to me.
What happened at the end of the night?
He could have shot me.
Shot it somewhere anyway.
Well, I didn't really have much choice, to be honest.
How?
With you. Because if I'd have gone out of the house, I didn't even know where I was, you know, to be honest with
so
you.
So you'd rather run about the house inside it with your brand knickers on?
No. That's
terrible, isn't it? So I always like to ask the question, how does one, a gentleman, make the first move? What did he say or do?
Well, they say over there, you know what I mean? Things are quite basic. You know, there's no talking, it's straight to the point. Put it this way, any other girl from Scotland, any other girl in Scotland would turn around and say you raped her. But then she wouldn't have a chance because
why would you? There's a sexual activity.
There?
Well, how can you say you were raped? There's no proof.
Yeah. Anybody, because I knew him. I know where he's come, you know what I mean? I know what they're like. A girl, see a Glaswegian girl, she'd have thought, you fucking raped me, you know? She'd have called the police, they'd have said, well, what were you doing at the flat anyway? However, you know, they don't mess about. Well, I've never been with one.
But you would only see that if you were.
What?
Raped.
Well, I suppose you could see that in a
but
way.
Why
because
would
I
you?
Said to him, no. I said, no, no, no. No, I said, no, no. I said.
And did he take no for an answer?
He did at first, no, because there's like two rooms and like, you know, they're like here. And somebody else would come. You know, it's like two rooms, two bedrooms, but for two different people. Well, one that wasn't used. So he said, right, okay, he said, you know, go and sleep in there, right? What? No, wait till you hear this. So I thought, no, he won't come out. I kind of trusted him, you know, in a way, I kind of trusted him. So I gets into this bed, there's a nice bedroom, you know. Then all of a sudden the noise started up the stairs, right?
Is it coming from up the stair?
Aye, people coming in with a baby. Well, I couldn't sleep and I didn't know where I was and I was a wee bit frightened. So I led there and he'd been watching a film and it had gone awfully quiet.
Right.
You know, and I thought, oh, the lights are out, you know, because his big light was out. Do you know what I tell you, man? He'll come round this corner. And then anyway,
what happened on the night?
Listen, I'm telling you, right, I'm building up to that. So I thought, right, you know, because I had no cigarettes, cause not that much money. So I thought, I'll go in the kitchen and I'll get up. So I have this big quilt. I've told you this, I have this big quilt round me. I walked in the sitting room and he was like on the couch watching the film in the dark.
What film was he watching?
Oh, it was a French film all about war. All about the First World War. Speaks French and it's subtitles in English.
Right, so?
So I walked in this kitchen.
Did you meet your Waterloo or what?
I walked back in the kitchen to get a cigarette and I thought he was in his own room because the lights weren't on.
Right.
And he wasn't. Then he was behind the door. He was led out on the... Uh-huh. And I said... So I just said to him, I said...
Was there a tilt in his kilt?
Yeah.
I didn't have a kilt. So he said to me, I said, I can't say, I said, that noise. I said, go and tell them to shut up. He said, no. So I just sat down.
Right.
And I sat down and I was nothing to do with him because I kind of, you know, and I don't know, you know, when you're never, you know, in a strange place and all. You're making me laugh now.
Well, I've never been in a strange place with a brand pants on, with a quilt wrapped around me, with a Palestine that I've just met.
A quilt round. No, but I'd known him for a good few weeks, you know,
right.
And I'd come round this corner. And I went, yeah, I kind of like got to know him. It was a good laugh. I liked him as a person, because I felt a bit sorry, because I know I have a threat there.
Even though he was a Muslim?
I don't think he is.
Do you not think so?
He's Jewish. No, he doesn't know it. No, you would never in a million years think he was a Muslim. He'd been in Greece and France, you know. So anyway, so I just sat there, you know, and I started like watching. I kind of watched that film and I was smoking the cigarette. I said, go and tell them to shut up. He said, no. And I don't know what it was. He said, clever. He said, can you sleep or something? I said, no. And I kind of, dead psychic, you know. He said, come and lie, you know, like my dad.
Uh-huh.
Kind of thing. Oh, come and lie. You know, if you like Friday. Oh, I knew that. You know what I mean? Dead. But that's like psychologically. Right. So I went and led down next to him, then he pounced on me.
You're joking. And what did you do?
I didn't know what to do. And I said, you know, I thought I would.
Is a Palestinian circumcised or what?
Oh, aye.
Are they?
Yeah, oh, aye. They have to be all
are. You sure?
So I'm like, no, listen, I'm told it. Oh, sorry. So he didn't pounce on me, but then I was like, listen, you haven't told me a bit, you know, and I just thought to myself then, I thought, I didn't panic, but I just thought to myself, you must keep calm, because anybody, you know what I mean, he could have helped, you know, my granny was right. Jewish.
So you never had sex, huh?
Aye.
Right. Is it good?
Do you know, I'll tell you that well, he wasn't, I don't think... It's probably not been with a lot of women.
Right.
You know what I mean?
They're
shy. Aye, but they're kind of shy because they don't know how to.
Right.
But put it this way. You know, it was like being something like back in the Bible. I had no choice.
Honestly?
Honest to God, I had no choice.
What was it, the old knee in between the knees?
I can't remember, actually. I was quite rot. And then after, he said, you're my baby. You know, I said, I thought I was your friend. He said, you're my best friend. And then, why are you getting all cuddlesome? And then I said, I thought we were friends. And then after it, he kind of went like, he must have not, you'd put it this way, you know, and I was just like talking to him, having a laugh with him. He must have. Oof.
Right, come back in for a cup of tea. Right.
What?
Come back in for a cup of tea.
Coffee. Now I'm more bothered about this lesbian. What will I do? I'll send her in here.
Wait, come back there and we'll talk about the lesbian in a minute.
But the thing is, what he did about a week or so later,
right.
Now listen to this, this is our psychic. Comes right down the M8.
Yes.
Into Glasgow.
Uh-huh.
Walks straight into Borders, right, and he's pretending to look at something.
Thank you, thank you.
He's pretending to look at the books. It's almost as though he knows where I am. So,
but what I just looked at him and I didn't know where to
no.
I could guess.
This is after like a week and a half, and I thought, oh, fuck it, you know, I've not seen him. So I came off the M8. No, listen to me. I goes into Borders, and I just looked, and he was there. And I thought, oh, fucking unreal, you know. How do you
Was that
know
before
this?
Or after this?
After, the week and a half after. So then I went downstairs, because I only went in to go to the toilet. You know something? See, when I was coming out of the toilet, it was there. So I went, hello. And it was like this look kind of thing. He went, hi. And he kind of walked away. You know something? Every day, not today, oh, come on, I'm fine. Because I also thought he'll turn around the corner. Every time I'm in, he just happens to be there. And I was asking this guy, and he keeps like, you know, and this, I think he's a bit, because I know what they're like. He's waiting for you to go to him. Is that right?
Ah, well, don't let him play that hard
no,
to get.
No.
No, sometimes, see, after a man's had his wicked way.
Yes.
It takes a maybe it all depends what age you are, but it takes another wee while for your libido to gain momentum. Right? That means it takes a wee while for you to get another dose of the horn.
Who? Him?
No, any man.
What, with the same woman?
Right, okay, say it was me that was on the couch, and it was me that night, right? It would take me, see, for the next two or three days after, I would blank your phone calls, and then all of a sudden, bing, on the Thursday night, I would get another dose of the horn, and I would come looking for you.
I will, with them, because they're kind of like, shit, you know, he's not got, every time I used to see him anyway, he'd always have his pals with him, he's not got a lot of confidence.